How's it going, everybody? Scott Spreitzer here, DocSports.com, with our update for Friday, April 12, 2019. Free pick coming up in just a moment. First, a quick note. If you've yet to become a member over at DocSports.com, just want to give it a trial run. Can't think of a better way to do it. You click on the link below the video, get set up for a free $60 account. Use those free $60 on any of my daily packages over at DocSports.com. Again, all you got to do to get the free $60 account is click on the link below the video and get started. Here's what we got going on, by the way, if you're inclined to go over to DocSports.com and grab my daily packages. First of all, in the NHL, my first seven-star main event of this postseason. Aside on Friday, we've had 22 of these the last four postseasons, just over five per playoff season, and we've gone 16-6. We'll look to make it 17-6 with the seven-star main event on Friday night's playoff card. And again, it is aside from Friday. As far as baseball is concerned, perfect the last 2 days, including a five-unit winner on yesterday's diamond card. We've got two sides going for Friday in Major League Baseball. And if we win both, we'll not only be perfect the last 3 days on the diamond, but 8-2 in Major League Baseball going back to Sunday. So starting to heat up in Major League Baseball. And again, the baseball plays will be available on Friday at 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 a.m. Pacific. NHL plays around 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific. I already know who I'm on. I already got the analysis written up. You'll be able to grab that play on Friday morning in the NHL seven-star main event. Again, last night, had to settle for a split. We went 1-1. We had two totals, no sides on Thursday. But Friday's seven-star play is a side. One of the four games that we're going to be involved with. Excuse me, I should say that correctly. We don't have four games that we're playing on Friday, just the one, the seven-star play. But again, there are four games that you can get involved with on Friday's card if you wish. We are just involved in one of those. We have one side. It's rated seven-star main event. We'll look to go to 17-6 with our last 23 playoff main events going back four-plus seasons. Couple of quick notes, by the way. On Friday night's NHL, obviously Tampa Bay needs a win or they go down 0-2 going back to Columbus. There's a team that can win down 0-2 going on the road, but obviously they want to get back on track tonight after blowing that 3-0 lead in Game 1. Pittsburgh and the Islanders, as close as it gets. This one, to me, is the one game that I will certainly be staying away from no matter what, because I think it's an extremely close matchup and we're going to just watch the game between the Penguins and the Islanders. St. Louis and Winnipeg, obviously the Jets have to win here. They're down 0-2 going on the road. And playing at St. Louis with the way Jordan Binnington has been playing, boy, I don't know if the Jets can overcome an 0-2 deficit going on the road for the next two games. If you saw that first game, you had Winnipeg get up 1-0, but Binnington kept his team in the game until a couple of goals were scored in the third period. And they've been wearing teams down between the ears and from a physical stature basically since January 1st. It's what they did. They also had a little bit of puck luck. Listen, that third period game-tying shot by Perron from the point, there were at least five bodies in front of the goalie, in front of the net that shielded the vision, and the puck finds the back of the net. But give Perron credit. He had a fantastic game, especially, the final 20 minutes, 30 minutes, maybe half the second period and all of the third period. And then you had the game-winning goal with about 2 minutes left from Bozak, and boy, did he receive the pass of the night, backhanded pass from behind the goal. Threads the needle between two Winnipeg defenseman, lands in the back of the net with the shot from Bozak, and they go on to win. So Winnipeg in a fight for their lives. I've seen as high as 120, 122. Seen some 113, 114s out there. Winnipeg laying that price. The late game, Vegas at San Jose. Can Vegas find that sweet elixir to the way they were playing when Mark Stone first became a member of the Golden Knights? They reeled off 10 wins in 11 games. Fleury gets hurt. They go the last 2 weeks of the season or whatever it was, basically with their backup Malcolm Subban on the ice. Team lost their confidence. They weren't attacking on the offensive end with that feeling that if they made a mistake, they've got Fleury behind them who could take care of most mistakes and erase those mistakes because it was Subban. And it looks like it changed their game a little bit, but they can get back on track. Listen, here's the thing. I was at game one in round two between Vegas and San Jose last year. Vegas won the game 7-0. San Jose looked like they had no business being on the same sheet of ice. Next game out, game two in Las Vegas, San Jose evens up the series. And a 4-3 win and takes it back to San Jose. So as bad as Vegas looked, as good as San Jose looked, it could flip around. You could see Vegas come out hard and win this game. Listen, Mark Stone played well in game one. So did Max Pacioretty for the most part. I'll tell you what the key is. You better get your shit together if you're Nate Schmidt and Ryan Reeves, because Nate Schmidt might have had his worst game as a member of the Vegas Golden Knights. Ryan Reeves was disappearing all night. And you're going up against a defense that is very offensive when it comes to the San Jose Sharks. Their offensive defensemen were, to me, the difference in the game the other night. So I think Vegas comes out with some intensity, but they better play a full three periods, and the defensemen for Vegas have got to pick up their game. There's no doubt about it. So just a couple of thoughts on the games. And again, one of those happens to be a big seven-star main event for us over at DocSports.com on Friday. All right, let's get to our free pick for Friday. We're going to turn to Major League Baseball. I think we're going to keep picking on those Kansas City Royals. Boy, we had Seattle yesterday as a premium pick, and one of the big reasons is that KC bullpen, which is terrible, and the great Seattle bats so far through the first 12, 13 games of the season. And what we saw, listen, Seattle's down, I think, going into the sixth inning, but they scored five runs off the KC bullpen, tied it up with two runs in the ninth. They win it in the 10th. This KC bullpen is an absolute mess. Their ERA is closing in on 8. I don't have a problem so much with Keller, who's pitching on Friday, the starter, but after he leaves the game, I mean, that team is just a disaster waiting to happen. And I know Cleveland hasn't been scoring a ton of runs, but this KC bullpen might be just what the doctor ordered for the Tribe to start scoring some runs and getting some extra base hits. And I think they're going to be able to take care of KC on Friday and continue the Royals' woes. The Royals were in a great spot heading into the later innings to win that game, including a two-run lead in the ninth, but that bullpen failed them miserably. So, listen, let's go against them here for a free pick. We're going to go with Cleveland on the road over KC. Now, the price is about $1.50, so it's not cheap. But again, we think that they'll get to that KC bullpen just like Seattle did in their series with the Royals. All right, again, here's what's going on over at DocSports.com on Friday morning. You can grab my Major League Baseball. Two sides on Friday. We look to stay perfect the last 3 days. The seven-star play in the NHL, we look to extend that 16-6 four-year run with our main events in NHL playoff action. And by the way, NASCAR, it goes on Saturday this week. We had a couple people ask us. The race at Richmond is on Saturday. Our picks for both NASCAR and for Saturday's UFC will be available after 11 p.m. Pacific time Friday night for Saturday's cards. That's 2 a.m. Eastern time Saturday morning. Again, NASCAR and UFC available early this week, Friday night, 11 p.m. Pacific, over at DocSports.com. All right, the Indians, again, are the free play today. Let's put it in the win column. If you like these videos, click on that thumbs up button. Be sure to subscribe. And we do appreciate, by the way, those who have done so thus far very much. Scott Spreitzer, DocSports.com. Best of luck on Friday. See you Saturday morning, 4 a.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Pacific.